Today we are going to see one of the more important and interesting subject, that is machine design. Every mechanical engineer should have the basic knowledge of the concept of design of machine elements so that he can use and apply these concepts when he is actually working in the industry. Now, in this session, we are going to discuss two points. One is the brief introduction and definition of machine design. And then we are going to see the basic procedure of design of machine element. Now, machine is a basic resource or the core resource of any manufacturing industry. Machine adds value to the product. All industries, automobile industry, textile industry, sugar industry, chemical industry, petrochemical industry, all industries use machineries which convert raw material into finished product. Now we'll take the example of two-wheeler, that is a bike. A bike has a various parts, that is engine, which is a core or heart of that particular of the bike. Then we have gearbox, we have clutch, brake, we have wheels, we have chassis. It has a seat, it has a fuel tank, it has a handle. So these are basic elements that it constitutes the mechanical system. And all parts, all these parts are produced by using the machines or machineries. Now design of machine is related to design of new machinery or new machine or modification of existing machinery. The machine is designed by considering the need and the requirement of the customers. Now let us see the definition of machine design. There are many definitions, but we are going to discuss a definition which is all inclusive. Now the machine design defined as use of scientific principle, technical information and imagination which will describe the machine or mechanical system to perform the specific function economically and efficiently. So what are the different scientific principles? In older days, machines were designed by using the rule of thumb. But the modern machines are designed by using systematic procedure and by using scientific principles. So the scientific principles, those are considered in the design of machine element are Newton's law of motion, Boyle's law and Charles law, Bernoulli's principle, D'Alembert principle, so these principles are taken from the various disciplines, that is physics, applied mechanics, statics and dynamics, thermodynamics, fluid mechanics. Next, the designer should have a knowledge of technical information. So, he should have the technical knowledge and information with respect to various elements of machine, that is, belt, bearing, shaft, key, cogwheel, lever, gear. These all constitute the elements of machines. And then the designer uses its skill and imagination to produce the configuration which will fulfill the requirement. And all these is used to specify the function that it should happen more economically as well as efficiently. Now let us go to the second point, that is basic procedure or design of machine elements. Now first step is specification of function. The machine consists of different elements. As I told you, it consists of bed, it consists of chair, it consists of bearing, shaft, key, coupling. So the designer first has to specify its function. Let us say the bearing. The function of bearing is to support the shaft as well as to confine the motion. The function of key is to transmit the torque from the shaft to the adjoining mechanical element which is mounted on the shaft. It can be coupling, it can be gear, it can be pulley. And then let us say a spring. A spring in a spring lock is used to store and release energy, whereas spring in a spring balance is used to measure the force. So the first thing that the designer has to do, he has to specify the functions. Now next, he has to determine the forces. The forces are categorized into two types. One is external forces and another is internal forces. External forces are the useful forces which we calculate from the energy, power and torque transfer. Let us say a gear that has been mounted on the shaft. Now the power is being transmitted and that is converted into torque. Power is equal to 2 pi L into torque upon 60 into 10 raised to 6 if it is in case of kilowatt. And torque is equal to force into radius. So we determine the forces. So external force is a useful force. Now other forces are the forces due to static condition, that is dead weight, force due to friction, force due to temperature gradient in case of thermal or thermodynamics, force due to inertia, force due to centrifugal action or centrifugal force. So the designer determines the forces acting on the body which will help in the process of determining the dimensions or in the process of design. Now next step is selection of material. This is one of the essential and important part. The right material plays a very important role. Now what are the requirements for selecting the material is availability, cost, mechanical property, and manufacturing consideration. The material should be available. The material should be economical. The material should have the necessary mechanical property and it should be manufacturable. Now, what are the different mechanical properties? The mechanical properties are elasticity, plasticity, toughness, resilience, hardness, brittleness. So these are the properties, and depending on the application, the designer has to consider these mechanical properties. and the values of some of the properties are available in design data book. The values with respect to the specific material is obtained by the designer from design data book. And the next important thing is that the material that has selected should be manufacturable. It has to be converted into the desired shape. So what are the various modes of manufacturing? Manufacturing by casting, manufacturing by forging, forming, and manufacturing by machining. So the selected material should have manufacturing consideration. Now we'll see some of the examples. Let us say a car body. Car body, the requirement is permeability. Car body is made up of low carbon steel. Engine block. It is having complex shape or the gearbox casing. So it is made up of cast iron. Transmission shaft. The most commonly used material is plate carbon steel. Similarly, the crankshaft and connecting rod. So these are subjected to fluctuating force and they are made up of alloys. So these are the different considerations which are to be made while designing a component, and that becomes the part of basic procedure for design of machine element. Now let us say a transmission shaft supported between the bearing and the various elements are being mounted over the shaft and it deflects up to certain limit. So if it deflects, it affects the adjacent or the part that has been related to this particular shaft. So it is considered, if the deflection goes beyond certain limit, then that is failure by elastic deflection. Next is failure by general yielding. So we know the stress strain diagram. For ductile material, as per the Hooke's law, stress is proportional to strain within elastic region. So this is elastic region. If the load acting on it is removed, the body regains its original position. But if the load goes beyond this, then it goes into the plastic stage. So if it goes into the plastic stage, it cannot regain its original position. So that becomes the failure by general yielding. So this is most commonly for ductile material. And then the failure by fracture. It is sudden. In case of brittle material such as cast iron, the failure is sudden. Now these are the three modes of failure. Next is determination of dimension. Now the designer determines the dimension and he determines the dimension on the basis of alloy constraints. you have a circular rod having diameter D and it is subjected to tensile force P. It is subjected to tensile force P. Now it fails due to tensile stress, so sigma T will be equal to P by A. Stress is equal to force upon A. Now the sigma T is permissible tensile stress. Sigma T is permissible tensile stress in Newton per atmosphere. P is applied force in Newton and A is resisting area in atmosphere. Now for this it will be P upon 5 by 4 is, that is area of a circular cross section. Now from this, by using the permissible stress, which is yield tensile strength divided by factor of safety, and by using the force, we can calculate or determine the dimension. Similarly, the component is subjected to compressive stress, shear stress, bending stress. On the basis of those consideration, the dimensions of that particular element is determined. Now next step is design modification. So design modifications are done on the basis of, from the point of view of assembly and manufacturing consideration. So a designer has to consider the assembly of the all the parts together, as we see saw in the example of automobile, two-wheeler, bike. And he has to also see whether from the point of view of manufacturability. As I told you, the manufacturing processes are casting, forging, forming, machining, etc. So depending on that, he has to take into consideration this manufacturability and he has to make the necessary modifications. So designer has to work together with the shop floor engineer or the production engineer from the point of view of making the modification and from the point of view of manufacturing consideration. And the last step in the design is preparation of working drawing. The last step is preparation of working drawing. So the working drawing is in the form of showing the dimensions tolerances, surface finish grades, and some of the time the heat treatment required. So this particular working drawing should be clear, concise, and it should be So these are the stages or the basic steps in the design of mechanical or machine element. That is, first you specify the function, what function it performs, you determine the process, external, internal, you select the material on the basis of different criteria, decide or take into consideration different failure criteria, that is failure by yielding, failure by elastic deflection, and failure by fracture, then you determine the dimensions or do the calculation of dimension, you make the design modification, and then the last step is preparation of working plan. So in this session we discuss two points. One is a brief introduction of the subject of machine design and a discussion about definition of machine design, and then we discuss the basic procedure, the steps involved in the basic procedure for design of machine.